Hi, my name is Katie Lewis, and I have a learning disability. And I start with this admission because I think that this, more than anything else, has really shaped the kind of work that I do. And when we think about disabilities, we often think about them in terms of deficit. So a piece of a brain that's not quite there. And I heard this. Katie has a deficit in phonological awareness. Katie has a deficit in phonological processing. Katie can't read. Katie definitely can't spell. And I think that this focus on deficits isn't good for students, it isn't good for teachers, it isn't good for parents, and it's definitely not good for researchers. And so I argue that we need to think about disability in terms of difference. There are real differences in how my brain works. To this day, I can't sound out a word that I haven't heard spoken aloud. I have a lot of trouble reading out loud, even children's books. Right? This is a real difference in how my brain works. And yet, I have this job that requires me to read and write really fluently to be able to do it. So my research is about math learning disabilities. And math learning disabilities are a difference in how students process number. And we estimate that about 5 to 8% of students have a math learning disability. And right now, researchers are going about trying to identify the deficits. They're trying to see what kinds of errors students with math learning disabilities are making. And so in my work, I really try to take more of a difference approach. And I'm going to tell you about Taylor, who is a really exceptional student who has a math learning disability. And yet she decided to major in statistics. And so I met her when she was a senior about to graduate. And one day I asked her, how would you solve the problem 8 times 3? And I'll give you guys a second to think about how you would solve the problem. So it took Taylor over 10 seconds to solve this problem. And so I asked her, how is it that you solve that problem? And she says, well, I know my doubles. I know 8 and 8 is 16. And I know I need to add another 8. And 16 is close to 20, so 20 minus 16, that's 4, so I take that 4 away from the last 8 I need to add, and that's 4, and so I add 4 to 20, and I get to 24. So what she's doing is she is doing something much harder than what most people do, which is just retrieve an answer from memory, and it takes a fraction of a second. She's solving 4 embedded calculation problems and keeping those numbers in her head. And so I said that she was exceptional. She has developed all sorts of ways of compensating for the way that her brain works differently. So one of the things that she described doing is, she called it sounding out the math. And so she gave me an example. She's like, when I was learning arithmetic and I saw the problem 3 plus 2, what I would do is underneath it I would write THREEPLUSTWO. And once she had done that and was able to read the words, then she could solve the problem. And this is a kind of compensatory strategy that she used all the way through her upper division math classes. So her notebooks are peppered with things like the probability of event A happening, given that event B has already happened. And so this was a strategy that she used throughout her life. And I said Taylor was exceptional, and she truly was. So not all students are able to compensate quite as effectively as Taylor is. But they all are doing things to solve problems in different ways because of how their brain is just slightly different than most people. And so I'm interested in really trying to understand those differences and trying to think about how we can design instruction that takes those differences into account and makes it more accessible for them. So right now I'm doing some work at a middle school, doing a fractions intervention, and then I'm working with community college students trying to understand how it is they think about algebra in really different ways. And ultimately what I hope that my work does is that it gets us away from this understanding of math learning disabilities in terms of deficits and helps us understand them in terms of difference.